So, sketch in 2023. What's happened? Well, quite a lot. Let's start with the big one. Smart layout, but everywhere. Now you can use smart layout wherever you need it, not just with symbols. So you can do things like this, and this, and this. And that's just scratching the surface. You should check it out. You can now import your Figma files right into Sketch, and it's easy. How easy? This easy. And we made receiving feedback way more convenient. Clients can now pin comments to specific parts of your design, and they'll now show up in the Mac app, and the iPhone app, and the all-new iPad app. You can reply wherever you see them, and you can resolve when you're all done. Speaking of iPhone and iPad, we added offline mode, local file support, support for Apple's handoff feature, and full canvas view on the iPhone. We've made a ton of updates and improvements to the Mac app, like better layer selection, easy multi-layer renaming, ready-made design templates, and here's one I love. You can now enable libraries for individual documents. This one makes the insert window so much nicer to use. We also redesigned the save dialog, so you can take full advantage of collections, another level of organization inside projects in your workspace. Over in the web app, we've redesigned the sharing modal, so it's easier to control who can edit, view, and inspect your documents. We've added sorting and filtering options, so you can find that file you need fast. And we've added support for dark mode. Finally, our new web prototype player loads a lot faster and supports more immersive designs. Oh, and there's just one more thing. We're back on the Mac App Store. So yeah, 2023 has been a pretty big year for Sketch. And why do we do it? Because of you. We love seeing the amazing things you create with Sketch. So don't be shy. Show us what you're making over on the community forum. We'll see you in 2024.